you know, media weeks, it's just part of the game. I'm getting used to it. I'm going to get even more used to it as the fights go on. It wasn't really my thing at the start, being an element of fire, being in front of a camera, but I'm just getting into my groove and getting more settled. I'm getting more comfortable with everything being in my face, you know, like this guy right here. So no, it's all good, you know, I'm getting more used to it, you know, I'm learning more about myself. The more interviews you do, the more better you get and the more comfortable you become, and it's just like sweet buns then at the end of the day. Same question I would get asked. Over the last wee while, I would say, yeah, definitely. I'm fighting John Talk this week, but I've been asked more about Conor McGregor more than anything about my opponent. It's like, I feel like I'm actually fighting Conor McGregor. I'm preparing for Conor McGregor this week. So yeah, that would be the most. There's Matt Serra there. What's up, Matt? Up, how's it going, man? You all right?
You,
nice
man.
To meet you, man.
Hey, how are you?
Good. That's him there. But yeah, I've been asked that a million times, you know, and I don't know why it keeps coming up. Everyone wants to see it. So what? Let's get it on then. If people want to see it, that's fine. Let's put this fight on and get it done and dust it, and then that'll be the job done. Keep everybody quiet then for a wee while.
Black covers for 100 bad men, 100 black grapes so I can lay they ass in. I need 100 black preachers with a black sermon to tell from 100 black Bibles. Why we send them all to hell? I need 100 black coffers. Black coffers. Black coffers. Black coffers.
Obviously, I noticed the accent, to be quite honest. I knew him anyway. I saw his fight in Bristol, which is an hour away from my house, against Joe Duffy. I've always rated him. I know my manager rated him highly because there was another guy I used to train with called Kent Kalpenham, and he was going to enter a tournament that Norman was in, and he made a big fuss about Norman being in it and didn't allow Kent to go forward. So I always knew he was good. He's a really chilled out guy, a little bit hype about his weight sometimes, but he was fantastic. Great guy when I first met him. I didn't drink that night, so I remember all of it. I remember the freak show. He was fucking annoying anyway, but he was smashed. He sort of come past, and I can't remember the exact story of that part. And, oh yeah, Brad, I've just drank a bottle of vodka. And I was like, yeah, all right, cock face. You know what I mean? No, you haven't. And then as he walked out the room, I could smell the alcohol in his breath, and I thought, fucking hell, he was the other side of the room. All of a sudden, I heard screaming and shouting. I thought, fucking hell, that's a little Irish voice, Northern Irish. And I thought, Jesus Christ, he's kicking off. Anyway, Norman come downstairs and he was basically picking a fight with Mike Wilkinson. Made out he left his hat in the other room and he wanted to go in there and throw down with Mike, kick his ass and stuff. That was pretty much that. Anyway, towards the end of the night, he'd had, not Bushmills, that's like it was like some cheap shit, like Bells or something. Don't want to slag off something I've drank. And he was absolutely wankered. So anyway, he came in our room, and the next thing I started hearing, like a cat, you know, fucking regurgitating fucking hairballs, innit? Fucking, it was disgusting. But he wasn't like he was in a bowl or anything. Spies in the camp. Spies in the camp.
I know you're training with my opponent.
And basically, what it was. Fuck, I don't know. I was showing him all the hip throws I've never done in my life. I've been training for hip throws though, obviously, because of my opponent. But basically he wasn't aiming into a bowl or anything. It was just straight on the end of my bed, fucking disgusting, covered in like blood and stuff. I was literally about to go down to see the security and get an ambulance because he was in such a bad state. He asked who I was a few times, didn't remember me from the 4 weeks we were already together, or 5 weeks. I then dragged him to the toilet, and he was sick in the toilet, and it was fucking, he missed the fucking toilet. He basically shit and pissed himself. He full on grand slammed, fucking all over the fucking toilet, stank of shit everywhere. It was fucking horrible. And then Colin was the one who famously jumped up to be sick, ran into the fucking cupboard, missed the door, and then 5 seconds later, Norman woke back up, and he was sick everywhere, all over my bed, clinging onto my bed. It's fucking horrible. It's a very bad experience for him and fucking stank. And I got the blame. because I had a glass of wine before I went to bed. Somehow, it was my fault the next day, a bit of a fallout. Oh yeah, it was your fault. You got the drink out in the first place. I had a glass of wine before I went to bed. And they started downing vodka and fucking... The jelly babies, you put the jelly babies in. Skittle vodka shots. And that was apparently my fault.